IAS Academy welcomes you in the series of MCQs based on daily current affairs for helping you in the upcoming exam of UPSC Prelims 2020. So today we will discuss MCQs of 28 March, but so that you can download these PPTs from the link given in the description box below. And please take a pause when you see question on the screen and answer it first, then see the explanation part. And if you feel the video is going too slow, too fast, please adjust the speed of the video accordingly, as option is given in the YouTube video. And as we have been left with very few days, so work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos and try to get at least 7 questions correct out of 10. So let's begin our today's MCQ. So question number 1 is with reference to Essential Commodity Act 1955. First, the act empowers state government to declare certain items as essential and control their rising price. Second, public health is listed in concurrent list. So here, statement first is correct, second is incorrect. So option will be A, one only. So under the act, the center has notified to declare second and third place surgical masks, N95 masks and hand sanitizers as essential commodities till June 30, 2020 in wake of COVID-19 outbreak. And it has also issued an advisory under the Legal Metrology Act so that states can ensure these items are not sold for more than maximum retail price, that is MRP, and the center can include new commodities as and when the need arises and then take them off the list once the situation improves. And the act prevents hoarding and black marketing of such commodities, but the public health is a state subject, not a concurrent subject. That's why statement second was incorrect, and the primary responsibility to provide quality healthcare services to the people, including in rural, tribal and hilly areas, lies with state and UP government. Now question number 2 is with reference to right to conversion into another religion. So first, the right to conversion is explicitly mentioned in the Indian Constitution. Second, the Article 25 dealing with freedom of conscience to practice religion is restricted to Indian citizens. So here, both the given statements are incorrect. So option will be here D, none of the above. So there is no express provision for conversion in the Indian Constitution, but still it is interpreted that the right to conversion is implicit under Article 25, which emerges from freedom of conscience. And Article 25 deals with freedom of conscience and free profession, practice and propagation of religion. And Article 25 is not restricted to Indian citizens only, but also extends to all persons, including aliens. And the context is that recently Delhi High Court said that the right is a personal belief, and whether to convert to a different faith and not is an individual choice, and declined a plea for stopping or regulating religious conversions. Now question number 3 is with reference to National Crisp Scheme. So statement first, the scheme is a central sector scheme of Ministry of Women and Child Development. Second, it aims to provide daycare facilities to children aged 6 months to 6 years of working mothers. So here statement first is incorrect, second is correct. So option will be B here, second only. So this National Crisp Scheme is a centrally sponsored scheme, not a central sector scheme, under Ministry of Women and Child Development, and it is being implemented in all states and UT to provide daycare facilities to children between the age group of 6 months to 6 years of working mothers. And as per the scheme, crèches shall be open for 26 days in a month and for 7.5 hours per day, and the number of children in the crèche should not be more than 25%, not percent, actually 25 per crèche, with one worker and one helper respectively. And as per the recent data, there are 6,453 crèches functional across the country under the scheme till March 2020. Now question number 4 is, remission of duties and taxes on imported products in use is an initiative of which of the following ministries? So the correct answer is Ministry of Commerce. So option will be here B. So Cabinet Commission on Economic Affairs has recently approved the scheme for remission of duties and taxes on export duties for enhancing export to international markets, and the scheme is an initiative of Ministry of Commerce which aims to make Indian export costs competitive and create a level playing field for exporters in international market and to give a boost to employment generation in various sectors. And the mechanism is to be created for reimbursement of taxes, duties at the central, state and local level which are currently not being refunded and are incurred in the process of manufacture and distribution of exported products. And under the scheme, an inter-ministerial committee will determine the rates and items for which the reimbursement of taxes and duties would be provided. And the RoDEF scheme is WTO compliant and will be implemented with end-to-end digitalization. Now question number 5 is, Shahadzi Megha in news recently is a variety of which of the following? So the correct answer is rice. So option will be C here. So the University of Agricultural and Horticultural Sciences, Shivamogga in Karnataka has developed this new red variety of paddy that is resistant to fungal blasts, and it was developed under the hybridization breeding method by cross breeding the best among the Jyoti variety with that of Akallu, which is a disease resistant and protein rich paddy variety, and the new variety will be notified under the Indian Seed Act 1966, shortly after which it will become part of the seed chain. And the protein content in it is 12.48%, which is higher than the other seed rice variety, which is actually red rice variety. Now question number 6 is regarding Disaster Management Act 2005, which is recently in news. So statement first, the act extends to the whole of India. Second, the act provides for the effective management of disasters. Third, the act calls for the establishment of National Disaster Management Authority. Fourth, Prime Minister of India is the chairman of National Disaster Management Authority. So here all the given statements are correct. So option will be D, all of the above. So the act under section 8 enjoins the central government to constitute a national executive committee as well to assist the national authority, and this committee under section of the act is responsible for the preparation of national disaster management plan for the whole country and to ensure that it is reviewed and updated annually, and all state governments are mandated under section 14 of the act to establish a state disaster management authority as well. Now question number 7 is again related with Essential Commodity Act 1955. So I hope you will be answer it correctly. So statement first, the center can include no new commodities as and when the need arises. Second, the center can take these commodities off the list once the situation improves. Third, it cracks down on hoarders and black marketers of such commodities. So here all the given statements are correct. So option will be D, none of the above, because no statement is incorrect here. So this act gives consumers protection against the irrational spike in prices of the essential commodities, and the act defines an essential commodity as simply a commodity specified in the act, and without this act the common man would be at the mercy of opportunistic traders and shopkeepers, and it empowers the government to control prices directly too, and the government can fix the retail price of any packaged commodity that falls under the act, and in the present situation the government can intervene to regulate the supply and prices of masks and hand sanitizer and also notify their stock holding limits. Now question number 8 is with reference to sepsis. So statement first, it is a life threatening organ dysfunction caused by the body's immune system overreacting in response to an infection. Second, sepsis can only be triggered by viruses. So here statement first is correct, second is incorrect. So option will be A here, one only, and the second is incorrect because virus, bacteria, fungi and pesticides can trigger sepsis, and the cause of sepsis are usually pneumonia, wound infection, urinary tract infections or infections in the abdominal cavity, and many coronavirus patients have died of sepsis when the body's immune system goes into overdrive. And a comprehensive study on the frequency of sepsis and sepsis death was published in the Lancet, in the mid-January 2020, and nearly a quarter of all deaths worldwide are attributable to sepsis every year, according to the study. So it is in news related to coronavirus outbreak. Do remember it. Now question number 9 is, recently Spanish flu was in news, so you have to choose the incorrect statement regarding it. So in the given 4 options, the incorrect option is A, so option A will be answered. And the option A is incorrect because there is no universal consensus regarding whether the virus originated in Spain or in other words, no one knows where the virus originated, but it spreaded worldwide during 1918 and 1919. And in the USA, it was first identified in military personnel in spring 1918. And with no vaccine to protect against influenza infection and no antibiotic to treat secondary bacterial infection that can be associated with influenza infection, and control efforts worldwide were limited to non-pharmaceutical interventions such as isolation, quarantine, good personal hygiene, use of disinfectant, and limitation of public gathering, which were applied unevenly. Now question number 10 is, recently Khartoum was in news, so where is this place located? So the correct answer is B, Sudan. So here you can see in the map, this is Sudan and it is the capital of Sudan and is located where the blue and white Nile merges to form Nile, which is very prominent river. So here I am wrapping up today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And in the last, positive quotation is, success doesn't just find you, you have to go and get it. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos. Please do multiple revision of these PPTs. Subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest update of the videos. We will meet tomorrow with the next MCQs. So stay safe, stay healthy. Have a nice day and thank you. Thank you.